Hello everyone, this is Oscar Echo 5, Juliet Foxtrot Echo. Joe here with another video for the Fox Alpha Victor Alpha 5 antenna analyzer, vector antenna analyzer. And today we'll have a look at the VNWA software. And yeah, you can find it on the sdrkits.net homepage, as you just see on the screen. You download the installer with the current version. There's also a description how to install it on a Linux system. I will just cover the Windows installation and confirm here that you want to install the version, accept the terms and conditions, and choose a path where you want to install the software. I'm just putting it here on my G hard drive and continue on with the installation. Get another name for the folder. Yeah, I'm doing that just because I have it already installed. We don't need a license key, and you just can choose which user gets the desktop icon, and then the actual file installation is happening. And so installation is done, and the libusb Windows 32 has been installed, and the setup procedure is completed. And now we have launched it just using the icon on the desktop or using the start menu. And first thing is that you need to add the Delta Golf 5 mic kilo antenna analyzer from the options menu. This is the first step. So you will see again, and of course the vector analyzer is connected. First thing is that you need to select it. You see in the title bar that it is now available, and then you hit the options and setup and pick the correct COM port. And like in my last video, it is again COM port 4 connected, and it's detected with the correct firmware. And this is the first step done. Yeah, what if it's not found? Probably a solder problem on the USB daughter board, or a general connection problem, maybe check the cable. First thing we need to do when the connection is successful, we need to switch to S11. This is the reflective detector port. And so this is the only one that is usable with the with this device. So you will just see here that I'm adding, right clicking on the on this part of the screen, and left clicking here or also right clicking to select the different options. Give it a try. I'm changing here the color for the trace number 3, which is the VSWR, and I'm changing it to a broader trace line. You can also go slow through the YouTube video to look through it again and again. Yeah, the first thing we need to do is to do a calibration, and for the calibration we need to define our calibration kit. So this is via settings, calibration kit. And we will use again the simple model custom calibration. This is the standard, and for that we need to add here in the second tab the parameters that we found at our supplied paper document that comes with the calibration kit. And we are putting in again open, short, and load delays. Watch that the order is slightly different than in the software as such. We are adding all the values that you find with your calibration kit. And then when this data is in, it's recommended to save the settings. It's also in the same menu, save settings, and I'm adding here just some comments to identify which calibration kit that I've used to do this calibration. So I just call it the calibration kit and the number. This is the serial number that is the ongoing number for this kit. And in my case, B015_2. And just adding my call just to have that in. And it asks me to save it, and I'm just for the moment saving it in the software, in the installation folder, and giving it again the name of my calibration kit. You are free to do just as you prefer. This is the first button, and now it's important to know that the calibration is always done for the currently selected frequency range. And then on the lower part of the screen, on the x-axis, you see that the start is at 1 megahertz and the stop is at 60 megahertz. So the calibration that we are doing right now is only for this selected range. And similar to the calibration that you do directly on the vector analyzer, we will do again the short, the open, and the load. And so I'm connecting off screen, of course, always the parts of the respective caps from the calibration kit, and doing the short, the open, and you also see the traces in the background moving. So it is just going through the selected frequency range and doing the calibration. So this was just the open, and now I'm connecting the load. So the 50 ohm part of the kit, and also running through here the calibration, and you see now all the dots turned green, and we could save this calibration. I'm saving it here now as a master calibration. This is of course only for a limited range. It is possible to have multiple calibrations, so you could for example have a master calibration just for the shortwave areas. You could have one for 2 meter, for 70 centimeters. You can go for the full range from let's say 10 kilohertz up to 600 megahertz. I will show that in a minute. You can just change the frequencies by clicking on the start or stop part of the axis, of the x-axis. Double click that, and you can change the parameters there. And you see we did just a scan with the 50 ohm. So in the Smith chart, everything is in the center. But what we notice, the VSWR is just showing not anything suitable, so we'll need to adjust the y-axis settings. So our reference level is of course 1, so a SWR of 1 to 1, and the reference position, I'm correcting it now to 0, so the lower end of the screen is the optimum VSWR, and that's okay. We just close the window and do again another sweep, just doing a single sweep, and you can see the dark green progress bar moving on the lower end of the chart, and the trace line is of course not so clearly visible, so we are placing here a marker. So right click on the chart and add a frequency marker, and in the top left corner you can see all the parameters depending on which traces are selected. In that case, the frequency, the values from the Smith chart, and the VSWR. And as mentioned, I'm doing here for my use a master calibration 1 to 600 megahertz. So I've clicked on the lower left part of the screen where it says start equals 1 megahertz, and then again going via measure and calibration, and the video is a bit speeded up so that you don't need to wait that long. So again doing the short, the open, and of course the load, and now again in normal speed, and I'm saving this now as my master calibration. This is what I would like to use for the future. This is the frequency range that is of interest for me. And here under CalKit info, you can get again the information which calibration kit this is referred to. And just to demonstrate how this looks like, I've selected here now a range of 140 to 150 megahertz, and measuring a J-pole antenna that is, as I noticed, at least here when I'm measuring it here in the shack, a bit off frequency. So the optimum SWR is a bit too high. So it's in the 146 megahertz. This is of course not optimal. At 145/500, we are at about 1.31, which is still okay. Of course, outside using it on the open field for SOTA activation that I like to do, it's of course the conditions are a bit different. So, and just to show you that as well, I'm adding here another trace. So right click down there at the trace section, and we will just modify here the decibel trace to the impedance, and I'm just testing and going through the different options. Imaginary impedance, but it's this one is the correct one as far as I can tell. Again, we keep the blue color and the S11 as the data source, as the readings that we won't like to get. And you see the y-axis again is a bit off, so we are measuring here up to 1000 ohm, as you see on the top left screen. This is of course not of big interest and help for us, so we will again click here on the marker and change it. And I was just trying a bit to figure out how this works, this is the settings that I found. So the reference position should be of course 50 ohm, and the reference level, so upper level would be, I just decided to put it to 75 ohm. Oh no, it's the reference around 50. So yeah, this definitely works. So this is what happens in the scale that I've selected. You of course free to experiment and to play around with the different settings. You see that the Smith chart is now deselected, so it's just the XY coordinate system. And thanks for watching. Hope to see you again for another video. 73 Oscar Echo 5 Juliet Fox Echo.